saying from the business community side, and then we'll hit a few of our members for some questions.
Thank you, Mr. Ramesh, for the very detailed presentation, and Honorable Chief Minister for your comments and willingness to engage the United States and its private sector, and I was very happy as a professor at the university to talk about education research and agricultural research as well. So looking forward to continuing that conversation to set the scene. From a policy perspective, a month ago, the finance minister announced a budget and announcing the ambition of turning India into a $5 trillion economy. From the perspective of the state, if I may put you on the spot, given that we're off the record, what do you want from the central government to help you do the work in your state? What other reforms, what is the implementation of those reforms that is still lacking from the center that would enable Andhra Pradesh under your leadership to achieve its goals? And the second one is, I was very interested, I think a lot of folks around the room might be, to hear your thoughts on how to make Andhra and its residents more climate resilient. We've been hearing a lot of stories about water, drought, flooding, and of course the rising sea levels affects the state for the long coastline uniquely in many ways. I would love to hear your thoughts on how to engage the private sector, in particular a lot of technology and resources around this table to help build that resilience agenda. Thank you.
I think the central government's help, I think that is something what any state would require. All what I can say is we share a good relationship with the central government and with the neighboring states as well. In fact, first time we have a situation where Telangana state government will be working together in a very strong way, where interlinking of rivers is taking place with both states coming onto one central platform. So that's something which was never done before, never done before. Something is happening now. So bilateral relations are very strong. As far as the other part is concerned, what Professor asked, we spoke about desalination plants, we spoke about interlinking of rivers, we spoke about electrical buses. All these are components where environment is looked at in a more positive way. So phasing out of 11,000 and odd diesel buses and bringing all of them into electrical mode, 1,000 buses each, I think we'll be calling for a global tender. So it's a very strong, sustainable BOT model what could be evolved, because the current road transport corporation of ours is already in existence. It's just doing it with the diesel part, with the diesel bus. And per kilometer, the cost per kilometer on diesel works out around about 15 to 16 rupees. Whereas if the same were to be converted into electrical, it's just 1.3 units. So probably it could be 3 rupees if wind energy also were to be brought into this, renewable energy were to also be brought into that. You can start out with 3 kilometers, three rupees per kilometer, and it could slide down to even 50 paise per kilometer as well. And to bring about profitability into this corporation, the entire the workforce, that is the drivers and the cleaners, the drivers and the conductors, the workforce, we are absorbing them into the government so that this corporation could be cleaner. So this corporation need not be bothered about the recurring expenditure what would entail from the drivers and the conductors part of it. So by and large, this corporation now will become a very sustainable, strong financial model, which will help any big investment to come in a very big way. So this is a positive step towards cleaning up of the environment. So by and large, we are, we also want to bring about environment-friendly policies. We want to bring about, we want to change this pollution policy also fast. Big way. I want to bring about certain someone in the government handling the pharma part of it, as to what the numbers officially were and what the numbers unofficially were. The toxic waste officially recorded is 30,000 tons. The unofficial records speak about 1 lakh tons. So the balance of 70,000 tons is either going into the sea or it's being burned into the air. So I just want to, so we decided that, you know, we need to bring in certain professionals into this who have a lot of knowledge as to what they're talking about, especially in pollution. So we want to take care, we want to handle the entire procurement of waste so that it could be handled properly. These are a few things what, you know, we will be doing going down the line. So I think by and large, we want to promote environment.
Thank you very much. Picking up now on a theme that Dr. Ramesh brought up was the ease of doing business, which you can imagine. This is a business association that's paramount for our members. So it's great to see that is something that's high on your priority list. The one thing that I would just comment that it's great to have a single point of contact. We do that here in the U.S. with states, have a single point of contact. The key is that single point of contact is empowered to be able to drive the process. So it's that, you know, if you have a single point of contact, it still takes a year because that individual is not able to drive the process quicker. So we've just emphasized empowering of that single point of contact to drive the process through as opposed to just managing it across the different agencies. So but, we're very encouraged to see that, and especially with how you opened today up, you kind of give the underpinning for doing business in a region with honesty, trust, and political stability, which are paramount and key for businesses to thrive. One question is, AP has been known for certain sectors. We've talked a lot about agriculture, healthcare. What are the new sectors or the emerging sectors that you would like to encourage the business community, whether it be space, whether it be something in technology? What is it something that you would like to encourage American businesses to look at to come to AP with in order to grow and build?
Robert, as you said, I think the reason is, as you said, single point application. We just not want to just monitor that, we want to drive it. That's exactly the reason why we said it will be governed by the Chief Minister himself. I will be the chairman of that committee. And so that I think would set everything what the state is going to give, I think that would be done on a voluntary basis. And as far as everything what central government would have to be giving in, that we would pursue. And I think central government is also very proactive, and hopefully things will go off very smoothly. But not many of them require state central government's permission. So permissions, by and large, would be very speedy. And land and power and water, these are the things what would also be very, very, we will provide them. So I think we have absolutely no problems with that. And coming to emerging sectors, where I just listed out quite a few of them. Strong sea coast, what could be used, whichever way we want. Anything you want to export, we're there. Desalination plant, I just spoke about. Metros, we just spoke about. And BOT models, all these things can be taken up. Ports, we just spoke about. And then internal waterways. We have Buckingham Canal that could be revived, which would straight away connect the entire coast from north to Chennai, including coast all the way to Chennai. Ferrying cost is, of course, much, much, much cheaper than taking anything on the road and taking anything through the rail. Ferrying cost is much cheaper. So that would be a phenomenally big project. It could set a change. And I just spoke about electrical buses, and I said the bus corporation is very strong after removal of these employees from that part. And diesel versus electricity. Just spoke about research, bringing in from universities, food processing, improving the quality of our aqua and agriculture products. You know, something like what people like, anything what can, where agriculture could be harnessed properly. We are the place.
Okay, we'll open it up now for a few questions from the from our members. I believe we'll start off with Jacobs and Amir F. Takari, who heads up international development for Jacobs.
Thank you, Robert. Thank you, Your Excellency. I very much enjoyed the presentation this afternoon. I'm with Jacobs. We are one of the world's largest engineering firms and professional services firms. We have quite a lot of work in India, particularly with the Capital City Project, where Jacobs was the program manager. My question to you today is, what's your vision for the Capital City Project? Do you still see smart cities as an integral part of the development and future of AP going forward? Thank you.
So basically, smart cities is something what they're the future. See, ultimately, all the important cities would have to be turned smart. So that would be a priority. Vizag is one such place what is high on the priority. It's one of the, in AP, it could be termed as one of the most cosmopolitan places. So there would be a lot of focus on that, and anything you have on that, you're always welcome and supporting everything.
Nelson Cunningham, President of Clarity and Associates.
Thank you so much, and thank you for making this one of the first stops on your visit. I have been was a longtime board member of the U.S. India Business Council, and I'm currently a board member of the Atlantic Council, so I think you could not have picked two finer institutions to host you today for lunch. My question relates to one of the issues that came up over and over and over again in the presentation, which is providing your people with health care at a reasonable cost. One of the issues that we have seen over the years that is one of the most difficult in assuring affordable health care is the cost of pharmaceuticals. And I wonder what your strategy is for dealing with the cost of pharmaceuticals to provide broad access to your people.
Andhra Pradesh has got a strong coastline, as I just spoke about. There are a lot of pharma companies already prevalent in AP because of its strong presence. What we are wanting to do is the FDA norms, the World Health Organization norms, the WHO norms. These are the things what in procurement to state government entities was not a factor. But now, after we have come into power, in fact, coincidentally, just a couple of days we had a review meeting with the health department, and in that department, just a couple of days ago, we decided that, you know, henceforth procurement norms should be at least WHO. This is something what we have also taken into consideration. Because until and unless the quality of the medicine given, until and unless it is improved, and where, you know, until it is improved, it doesn't yield good results. That's one of the very, very important points we also understand, and we're doing it in a big way. You know, in this process of doing whatever we have in mind, I think it's going to be one of the most talked about model what we're contemplating. If this goes well, this entire country would actually look up to us. We're wanting to ensure that, you know, anything what is above 1,000 rupees is covered. So for that, you know, we're making sure that the number of diseases what come under the insurance policy, that they're increased. The national policy speaks about around 900 or odd diseases. We wanted to take it up to 2,000. And then we wanted to improve the quality of our domestic internal hospitals. So every hospital, we want to revamp them in a very big way, so that every hospital is to the standards, to the rest of the Indian standards what we have. We want to upgrade every hospital to that level. So we wanted to bring about all these changes. So hopefully in the might see some changes, but I won't.
Right, so, okay, being cognizant of time, Chief Minister, what we'd like to do, we've got three quick questions. I will call, I've got three cards up. If you'll name company, quick question, we'll give them all three together, let you react to them, and then we'll make sure we're on time.
Okay.
That sound good?
Thank you for coming. Amana from Fiki. I just had a question about skills development, especially in light of your 75% reservation for in-state employees and how we can help upskill the workforce, especially as India is now trying to attract manufacturing jobs in IT and tech. So is that going to be government-led or are you going to be working with the private sector? Thank you.
Thank you. Steve.
Thank you very much. Steve Jacobs, Philip Morris International. Not so much a question as an offer. We used to be a major producer of leaf in Andhra Pradesh, and I was listening to your comments about agrarian reform, and we would very much like to come in and talk to you about our ideas of how we can reform the production and marketing system that would bring greater farmer income and value to through good agricultural practices to the farmers in that AD. Be open to that, we'd like to talk to you about it.
Great. Thank you very much, Steve. So we've got one on finance and worker development.
This one is the masala ones we just talked. These kind of avenues we have to look at it. Every avenue what needs to be looked into where cheap financing is available, the cost of the funds are low. I think that all those areas would have to be looked into. So I think even PV Ramesh himself, the background itself is he was REC chairman, rural electrification chairman, and he was finance secretary as well. Those kind of details, if you want to be, if you're interested, you could spend more time with you on that particular details. As far as the skill development is concerned, this is one area where we would have to focus on. So to begin with, you know, to begin with, if we're taking one parliament as a unit, we have 25 parliaments. We're taking one parliament as a unit and identifying one superior engineering college where the facility could be set up. And then in that facility, which would be funded by the state government, we would be involving the local industry, asking them what kind of skills they would require. Somebody is coming forward to set up a factory. We would ask them beforehand as to what are the qualifications that you require, what are the skills that you require. And we would be training them, training our children to suit their requirements. So it would be a combination of the local industry as well as the government who would be imparting training in these colleges that we identify as a hub where training could be given. And as far as taking external help, like as you said, that would be welcome. In fact, you know, any evaluation that could be brought about that would give confidence to the international community, that would give confidence to the people who are wanting to come and set up industries. I think that would be an important part. So anybody who's of that credibility, who holds that kind of certification, that kind of credibility, and would help give confidence to the people who are coming here and wanting to set up their base here. I mean, it will be welcome for us. It will be a welcome decision.
Prdesh will take
this up. The other end was talking about tobacco processing. And ITC is also very strongly present in our state. And we would definitely welcome that. This is one thing that requires, because only when there is competition, there is better rates. So we would definitely welcome that.
We all like competition. Well, that concludes our question and answers. Before I move to thank the Chief Minister, I wanted to first thank members of our team here that put this all on today. It's, you see them all running around here, Sid and Jay and Jeff G and Lauren, the whole team here, really a first-rate job. We're honored to have our members here today, but most of all, we're honored to host the Indian delegation from AP with the officials that you brought with you, but also Ambassador Shringla. And once again, your partnership and working with you has just been superb since you've been here since January. Mr. Chief Minister, you've been here, or you've been in office for just a couple months. You've already made a huge impact. We look forward to increasing that impact. We appreciate sincerely that we're your first stop on this visit. I look forward to seeing you at Notre Dame next week, and we wish you the very best of luck. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, security has asked that everyone remain seated while the Honorable Chief Minister exits, and then we'll depart.
May I take this opportunity to acknowledge the grateful thanks for USIPC for organizing this function, especially for Mayor and President, Honorable CM, to serve this in an honor.